Hello everyone, this is chapter 3, Earth Movement and Seasons. In this we will see changing seasons, curvature of Earth, Earth rotation on its axis, Earth tilt and revolution around the Earth, temperature belts on the Earth. We know we have a seasonal changes and constantly we in our surroundings in the course of year we see the changing in the seasons. India is a subcontinent and we witness broadly summer, monsoon and winter. And in South India, states like Tamil Nadu, Kerala or Andaman does not experience much cold during the winter season. But summer season is very brief in the northern eastern states. Most of the North India witness all the three seasons with warm summer, cold winter and rainy seasons. And in ancient Sanskrit literatures divides the year into six seasons, adding an intermediate season between each of the three main seasons, that is summer, winter and monsoon, and they have added a intermediate seasons called Ritus. They are Vasanta, Grishma, Varsha, Sharad, Hemanta and Shishira. And Vasanta is a spring season, Grishma is a summer season, Varsha is a monsoon season, Sharad is a autumn season, Hemanta is a pre-winter season and Shishira is a winter season. And these are associated with certain agriculture and festivals. Vasanta is the end of the winter season. And they are in this the festivals which are celebrated in this season are Vasant Panchmi, Holi, Ugadi, Gudi Padwa, Vishu, Bihu, Baisakhi and Pulnandu. And Grishma is the summer season, the hottest season. And Varsha is the beginning of the rains. And Sharad is the season where the sky becomes clear and monsoon crops ripens. And the festival celebrated here in this season is Deepavali, then Hemanta and then comes the Shishira, which is the winter season or the coldest period where, in which this season Himalayas region receives snowfall during this season. A number of harvesting festivals like Lohri, Pongal and Makar Sankranti are celebrated. And curvature of the earth, we having a, we know that our earth is a round, a ball like, and having a curvature, it is not having a straight, it is not straight, it have a curvatures, because due to the curvature of the earth, earth distribute distribution of heat, that is the sun rays over the earth surface is different. Near the equator is warm and the poles is not so warm as the equator. Earth rotation, Earth rotation on its axis. See how the earth is rotating. Earth rotates just like top spin. It rotates just on imaginary line which joins North Pole and South Pole called axis of pole. And this pole, this is an imaginary pole, this is called the axis of pole. And it joins the North Pole and South Pole. Earth takes how many hours? 24 hours to complete one rotation around its own axis. And moves from west to east. The rotation takes place from west to east, and this is the reason why we see all the things, that is sun, moon and stars appears rising on the eastern side and setting on the western side. And the foremost effect of the earth rotation is the daily alteration of day and night. As the portion of the earth's surface are turned first towards and then away from the sun, the variation in the exposure to sunlight greatly influence the local temperature and wind movement. Here you can see the this is the axis through which the rotation takes place. Earth rotates around its own axis from west to east, northern autumn and southern spring. Why we are telling and separately northern and southern seasons? Because of the tilting of the earth and the revolution around the sun, because of this tilting we faces different changes in the differences and changes in the seasons because of the tilting of the earth and its rotation around the its revolution around the sun. What happens this part here, the southern hemisphere is facing the sun, and so the southern hemisphere having a spring season and it is away from the sun, it is having a autumn season. When it comes here, now southern hemisphere is facing the sun and it is far away from the sun, northern hemisphere, and that's why northern hemisphere having a winter season during these months and southern hemisphere having summer season. And during these months, March, April and May. Northern hemisphere faces spring season and southern hemisphere faces having a southern autumn. And when it comes to June, July, August, northern hemisphere have the summer season and southern hemisphere have a winter season. And this is called the equatorial line. These are the spring equinoxes where day and night are equal. And this is the summer solstice where the days are longer and nights are shorter. This is called the upper from north. This is the north pole. This is the south pole. And upper side of which is called the Tropic of Cancer. And towards the south, the shortest day and winter in winter solstice. Shortest day and longest night. And this is the how the rotation of the earth takes place in 24 hours. For one completion of one rotation, earth takes 24 hours. And this is how, see, if western countries are facing daytime and eastern countries are facing nighttime, having a nighttime and when in 24 hours. And this is a revolution of the earth. There it is revolving around the sun. And to complete one revolution, it takes 365 days, 5 hours, 56 minutes for to complete one revolution. And this is the tilt. And how much it is tilt? 23.4 degrees it is tilt. And this is the reason we are having a difference in the southern hemisphere and northern hemisphere seasonal seasons. Changes in the seasons due to this tilting. We have a, if we are having a northern hemisphere having a winter, then southern hemisphere have a summer. If summer, winter in the southern hemisphere, summer in the northern hemisphere because of the this tilt. And this is how the day and night occurs. The dark portion is having a night and the brighter part which is facing the sun having a daytime. And this is how the winter and when it is facing up towards the sun, it's having a summer season and it is away means it is having a winter. This is how the seasonal changes occurs. And this is the revolution of the earth around the sun. How many days it taking? See here, days, winter, spring, and how the due to changes in the when it is revolving around the sun, how the changes are taking place in seasons also, summer, spring, winter, like that. And it takes to complete one revolution 365 days, 5 hours, 56 minutes. This is the revolution of the earth around the sun and the changes in the seasons. And here we can see the day and night and also the axis of pole, and then this is the equator, and how the changes in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere taking place. And these are the temperature belts on the earth. See here, on March 21st and September 23rd, what happens? And they will have a equal length of day and night. That's why these are called as equinoxes. And here on 21st June and 21st December, see here, on northern hemisphere having a winter season, on southern hemisphere having a summer season. Here also, here winter season and it is rotating, see the arrow marks, from west to east, from west to east, 21st solstice, then the changes in the day and night. And here it's a equinox. Why they have written equinoxes? Day and night are equal in length. Changes in the length of the day and night due to change in the seasons. That is, and the changes in the, that is first point of Aries, that is vertical equinoxes, 0 hours. If we take ascension, daylight is the same length everywhere on the earth. And in summer solstice, that is 6 hours right ascension, more daylight on northern hemisphere. And in autumnal equinoxes, 12 hours right ascension, daylight is same everywhere on the earth. And in winter solstice, 18 hours right ascension, more light on south southern hemisphere. And this is a declination measured from the central equinoxes. and these are the degrees south, from 45 degrees south to and north, 90 degrees south. Like that. See here, I will show you. This is how the 90 degrees north from northern hemisphere NN, and here this is because south, 45 degrees south, 90 degrees south, 0 degrees, 30 degrees north, 60 degrees north, 90 degrees north. And these are the how the vegetation changes due to changes in the seasons. This is in the spring season where it is covered with the snow plants, and in summer season how the leaves are green, and when the starting of the autumn season and the leaf changes into red or yellow color, and then it falls off and winter starts and it will be covered with the snow. And this is a picture of one tree showing all the four seasons, that is winter, spring, summer and autumn season. See here also, these are the fruits and vegetables which grow due to changes in the seasons. We have a seasonal fruits, these are the seasonal fruits. In summer we can have a watermelon, like that. These are the winter fruits, vegetables also. And these are the months. During March, April, May, we have a spring season. June, July, August, summer season. September, October, November, autumn season. December, January, February, winter season. These are the animals which have the capacity to tolerate extreme cold condition. And they have some animals also go hibernation, and some animals will migrate, and some animals have the capacity to tolerate extreme summer also, like camel. We find it in desert conditions, and some animals have a body structure. See here, they are having a huge furs which protect their body from extreme cold, and they will maintain their body temperature. And these are the animals we find at different places, and due to the seasonal changes, the vegetation also changes, and animal habitats also changes, and the structure also changes, like that. Okay, thank you.